Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, now we are moving towards a new topic, that is catalyst and its general characteristic. So talking about catalyst plays a very important role in the reactions. So it is a part of the surface chemistry. The reason behind it is because there are also the types of the catalysts that we are going to talk about, that is a heterogeneous catalysts as well as homogeneous catalysts. So in this case, basically we are talking about how the catalyst can affect the rate of chemical reaction and what are the general characteristics of the catalyst. Let us talk about it. So talking about catalysts, so let us understand the definition of it and let us understand later on that is what are the general characteristics of the catalyst. So talking about the first one, that is the definition of the catalyst, and it is, that is a substance which when added to the reacting system increases the rate of reaction without itself being consumed in the reaction. They are known as catalyst. So the main role of the catalyst is to actually alter the rate of reaction. So in this case, basically we have written here that it increases the rate of reaction. Means if we have to achieve the product while reacting two reacting mixtures at least, so we can get the product as soon as possible. So this reduces the time, but meanwhile we can get our product very with a short period of time. So this is what the rate of reaction is. So this can be attained, that is if higher the rate of reaction, that is what we need, we have to add a catalyst. So in any kind of reaction, or basically if I'm talking about an irreversible reaction, we can add the catalyst so as to get the product in a very short duration of time, and that is what the role of the catalyst is. So there are also certain examples that we are going to talk about, but let us understand that what are the general characteristics of the catalyst. So usually catalyst is basically a phenomenon where a reaction is being proceeded with the help of a catalyst when it has been added to it. So therefore there are two types of the catalyst, that is homogeneous catalysis and the heterogeneous catalysis. So we are talking about, generally we are talking about the both of these types, and now let us understand what are the general characteristic of this kind of catalyst. So as I've said earlier also, that is for an irreversible reaction, suppose if we are adding a catalyst, then we could see that since the rate of forward reaction will be more, so that's the reason that the product or that could be attained in a very short period of time. So similarly, that is when we are talking about, that is a reversible reaction. So what happens when a catalyst is been added in a reversible reaction? So whenever a catalyst has been added in a reversible reaction, then because the equilibrium has been maintained between, that is the products and the reactants, so the rate of forward reaction and the rate of backward reaction, the both will be the same, and that's the reason that the catalyst will not have the effect on the reactions which are showing the reversible reaction. But yes, one thing is sure, that the equilibrium that has been maintained, so that equilibrium can be attained very soon. So that is what the first point is, that is in a reversible reaction, the chemical equilibrium is attained faster. So we can attain the chemical equilibrium very much faster. In spite of taking too much of time, we can add the catalyst in such kind of reactions and we could attain the chemical equilibrium. And that is how that the catalyst won't affect the reactants or won't affect the product, but meanwhile it can it can increase the rate of reaction. So that is what the main thing of catalyst is. So now let us talk about the next one, that is even small amount of catalyst can cause considerable increase in the rate of reaction. So yes, even a small amount of a catalyst when it has been added in a reacting mixture, then what happens is because of the reacting mixture, they react with each other because of the presence of the catalyst, and we could say that the product is been formed very soon. But meanwhile, we should also note that catalyst is the one that doesn't take part in the reaction. So meanwhile, suppose if one reaction has been occurred, that is suppose if A is reacting with B so as to form C plus D in presence of a catalyst. So now the catalyst is again retained, and that catalyst that has been regenerated, that will again react with other molecules of A and B so as to form C plus D. So meanwhile, in this case, basically even small amount of catalyst has been needed so as the reactant will react with each other very fast, and we could get the products. So this is what the second point was, and now let us understand the third point. So when it comes to thermodynamics, we should understand that whenever a reactant has been forming a product, it should cross the barrier or energy barrier, that is what we know as a potential barrier, and that is what we also call it as activation energy. So whenever a reactants, or whenever two reactants, they react with each other, they need some kind of energy so as they could overcome through that energy and they could form the product, and that kind of energy or that kind of barrier is what we call it as activation energy. So what happens when a catalyst has been added in a reacting mixture? So the catalyst plays a very important role in reducing the, that is, activation energy, or it lowers the activation energy. So because of which, basically, the reactants, they will react with each other and they have to cross a small, energy barrier, and easily we could get the product that is, suppose if A plus B are the reactant, then we could easily get C plus D. So this is all that I am going to explain with the help of a graph also. So let us understand the second one, that is the next one. So a catalyst does not affect the energy of the reactants and product. So yes, even this is the main thing that we are going to talk about. That is, the reactant and the product, they have a particular energy, and that particular energy is not being affected by the catalyst. And but yes, one thing is sure, whenever a catalyst has been added in a reacting mixture, it will form a transition state, which is also known as a complex, which has basically higher energy. So that higher energy is now been reduced because of, we know that catalyst lowers the activation energy, and that's the reason that the products can be obtained that is very soon, because of the rate of the forward reaction is, suppose if it is more, then we could get the product as soon as possible. Obviously that the products that are being formed, that could be attained very soon. So talking about the energy, the transition or the transition state has the higher energy, and that could be affected by the catalyst, but the energy of the reactant and the product, that cannot be affected by the catalyst, and there would be as it is. So let me explain with the help of a graph, but before that, let me clear this point also. That is, the magnitude of the heat of reaction is not affected by the catalyst. Yes, the heat of reaction, obviously we know that a reaction can be an exothermic also, as well as you could also know that it can be endothermic also. So the energy gap between the reactant and the product is basically known as heat of reaction. So even the heat of reaction can be positive, can be negative also. And that heat of reaction cannot be altered because of the catalyst. So this is what I want to talk about. So this whole point can be cleared with the help of a graph that I am going to discuss about. So let us talk about that thing. So this is the graphical representation that I am going to talk about, that how the catalyst affect the rate of the reaction, and how does it affect the, that is, the activation of the reaction, or we could call it as activation energy. So suppose this is a graph that I have mentioned over here, and it represents that is the progress of reaction, as well as the energy that is being required for the reactant so as to produce the product. But we have also mentioned that the reactants have a particular energy, and while that of the product also will have a particular energy. So for that, suppose if I'm representing here, that is, suppose this is the energy level that I'm talking about, the reactant. And in our previous, when I was explaining, I used to say that it's A plus B, suppose it's the reactant. So here also, suppose if I'm considering that is the A plus B is the reactant, that is this one. So it's to form a product, that is suppose C and D. But A plus B cannot be converted into C plus D directly. Obviously, it has to give, take some kind of energy, and that kind of energy is basically known as activation energy. And that energy that has been required for the reactant, so as to convert into product, is basically known as activation energy. That is what we know. So, but that activation energy is formed because of whenever A and B, suppose if they are reacting with each other, and the intermediate has been formed, and that intermediate is the one which will have the highest energy, and that highest energy is the one which is called to be a transition state, and that can be represented in this way, that is, I'm going to mention about. So this is the highest energy if we observe, then this is basically known as transition state, and that is the reason that this is the one where we can find a complex, and that is because of A plus B. And whenever they will react with each other. So this is the product that we have. So suppose A plus B is moving towards, that is a highest energy to form, and this is what we could find, that this is the energy gap, and this energy gap is basically known as the activation energy. And so A plus B has to cross this energy, or this energy potential barrier, then only it will be converted into the product, that is C plus D. So if you observe, that is C plus D also have a certain energy. So even A plus B and C plus D also has a particular energy, that is the reactant and the product. So this is the one where we have not used, that is catalyst. And that's the reason that we could see that the transition state is having a higher energy, and that the difference between the, that is the reactant energy and this transition energy, is basically known as the potential barrier, or basically known as activation energy. But what if we use catalyst? So if we use catalyst, then the reaction would be in this manner, where the energy of A plus B, it will be the same, where the energy of the C plus D, it will also be the same. But meanwhile, we could see, or we could observe, that is, the transition state or the energy that has been required so as to convert A plus B into C plus D, it will now be, it will be lower. So now this difference, as you could see, that is, suppose if I am considering this as transition state 1, and this is the original, that is transition state. So by this, I could observe that the transition or the energy required to convert A plus B. So this is where we could find that is whenever we have used catalyst. So suppose if I am making this to be called as a catalyzed reaction, then we can observe that the energy required is now very much less. So I could say that suppose if I am comparing that is the EA, that is the activation energy for that is the original one. Suppose if I am measuring over here like this one. So the activation energy is more compared to that of the activation energy when the catalyst has been used. So this indicates that the product that could be obtained, it would be obtained in a very that is a less amount of time, and that is what the catalyst plays a very vital role. So here we have discussed about the energy of that is A plus A and B as well as C and D, that is the reactant and the product. But we have also discussed about the heat of reaction. So there will be no change in the heat of reaction. And what is that? That is, if I take out the difference between the reactant and the product, or the energy level between the reactant and the product, so this is what I could call it as delta H or heat of reaction. So this reaction is basically an exothermic reaction, because as we know that is the product that is C plus D has lower energy compared to that of A plus B, that is the reactant. So this indicates that it is an exothermic reaction. But even though by using catalyst we can't change the magnitude of the heat of reaction, so that is the reason the catalyst has the role to at least that is to increase the rate of reaction or to alter the rate of reaction. And meanwhile we could see that the path has also been changed, because the catalyst has a property to change the path, and we could get the product as soon as possible. So this is what we have, and this is what we have discussed about the points, like when we have discussed like the point number 3, 4, and 5, and it is all bit clear, I hope. So this is what I was talking about, and now let us move on to the further part. So now let us talk about the next point, and the next point is basically that is the catalyst cannot initiate the reaction but accelerate its rate. Yes, the catalyst doesn't that is initiate the reaction. In fact, it has only that is role to alter the rate of reaction, and that's the reason that is it increases the rate of reaction, or it can alter the rate of reaction, but it cannot initiate the reaction. So the initiation of the reaction, it will depend on the energy, but it not depend on the catalyst. So now let us move on to the next point, and this is very much important, because this will clear the every doubt that we are going to discuss about. That is, the catalyst is not consumed because it doesn't participate in the reaction. So the catalyst is a substance which when is added in the reacting mixture, it won't take part in the reaction, and or meanwhile we can't see the product to having the same catalyst in it. But we can see that the catalyst has been that is regained. So this is the special role of the catalyst, that it actually it increases the rate of reaction, but meanwhile we can get the catalyst back. So this is what I want to talk about. So let me give you a few examples so that we could understand it in a better way. Suppose we are considering a reaction where that is the SO2 has been converting into basically SO3 in presence of that is oxygen. But this is not a balanced reaction, so we have to balance it. So we could easily balance it with the stoichiometry values. But this reaction doesn't take place by its own. Suppose if we have to increase the rate of reaction, so we can't increase the rate of reaction by including only that is SO2, which is of gaseous state, oxygen, which is again of gaseous state, and SO3, that is sulfur trioxide, which is of gaseous state. So suppose if we have to increase the rate of reaction, so we are using a certain kind of that is catalyst, and that could be homogeneous also, and that could be heterogeneous also. So for example, that is suppose if I am using the catalyst like NO2, which is of gaseous phase, and as you could see that all that is the catalyst and that is the reactant and the product, they all are of the same phase. That is the reason it is called as homogeneous catalyst. But the part of it we could discuss it later on in the next section. But meanwhile, when you are talking about the catalyst, that is this reaction can be proceeded into that is two steps. So this is where I could show that is NO2 is acting like a catalyst. So the first step that is been it has been involved in this case is, suppose if I am writing in this way, that is the step number one. So this is what I want to show. So in this case, basically two moles of sulfur dioxide is being reacted with, that is the catalyst that I'm using over here is basically two moles of NO2. And suppose in this reaction, basically the product that we could get in the first step is two SO3 plus NO, and here we have two, that is balance the reaction. So I'm writing it over here as, or I'm balancing it with the stoichiometry of two moles of NO is being produced. And now in this case, basically, this is the product that we have, and now this product would be very much that could be helpful in that is formation of the product. So that is the original product, that is SO3. So as we have obtained over here, that is SO3 has been obtained, but what about this NO? So this NO is what we have to utilize it. So somewhere that is in step number 2, we could observe that is 2 moles of NO is been again reacted with, that is O2, so as to form, that is 2 moles of NO2. So this is what we have formed. And suppose if we have to give the overall reaction, then it will be, I hope you have got to know that what would be the overall reaction. And in this case, basically, I could cancel out this 2NO. And meanwhile, here also, this NO2 and this NO2 would be cancelled over here. And the only thing that has been left out is basically 2 moles of SO2 is been reacting with O2, so as to give, that is 2 moles of SO3. But here, as we have got to know, that is a that is NO2 which has been reacting in the first step, it has been again produced in the second step. So meanwhile, this is playing as a catalyst, because catalyst, even though if we are adding in the reacting mixture, it will again regain back after the completion of the reaction. So this is how I could see that this NO2 is now, so this is how I could see that is the NO2 is been again regained, that is in the second step. And that's the reason that NO2 is being called as, that is, the catalyst. While talking about the intermediate, yes, there is no role of NO over here. But if we observe in step number 1, that is 2 moles of NO is been obtained. But meanwhile, in the second step, that 2 mole of NO is now been consumed with the help of O2. And this is how we can get the catalyst back, that is 2 moles of NO2. So somewhere we could say that catalysts do take part in reaction. But in fact, after the completion of reaction, they are been regained. So we could say that the catalyst has not been, in fact, taken part in the reaction. But meanwhile, we could say that the rate of reaction has been increased. So in this case, let me tell you, that is the 2 moles of NO2 is acting like a, that is, catalyst, while that is 2 moles of NO or NO is acting like an intermediate. So this was one of the examples that I was talking about. And let us conclude this topic here itself, because these are the characteristics of what we have got to know about the catalyst, as well as we have also got to know what is catalyst. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you will share this video with friends. And don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.